Now that we have an understanding of how the bridge works, let's follow the complete process from beginning to end. Here we have a network with two interconnected bridges and five workstations. When we first turn the bridges on, all source address tables are empty. Typically, once a network device is turned on, it's never turned off. So, in most networks, the empty table only occurs when a device is powered on. With an empty database, the bridges have no idea where any devices are located. So what does a bridge do when it receives a packet? Well, think back to our last lesson and remember that the bridge floods unknown packets just like a repeater. Now let's take a look at the bridge's learning process. Device A needs to communicate with device C, so device A creates a packet and sends it out onto the network. Bridge X, which is connected to device A, receives and examines the packet and, as we just said, being unable to identify a destination path to C, it floods the packet out all its ports, except the port the packet arrived on. It would be pretty dumb to send it back the same path it came from, and bridges, unlike repeaters, are smart. The packet reaches the other bridge, bridge Y, and the same process of flooding the packet occurs. As you can see, the packet eventually reaches device C, however, that's not the end of the story.